welcome to another edition of Seamless Style, powered by Politics and Polaroids. I'm your host, Mr. Parker. All right. Welcome. For this episode, we're going to focus on lightweight outerwear. Now, you may think to yourself, lightweight outerwear, that leather jacket you're wearing looks like it's got a little weight on it. It does, but it's a natural raw cowhide. So even though it does have a little weight on it, it's still something that I probably won't wear in the cold of winter per se, or a late fall New York, late fall Chicago where it gets really cold. It's still considered to me a lightweight layering piece, right? But yeah, we're going to do lightweight outerwear pieces. I have a few pieces that I added to the collection over the past couple months, over the summer. And I'm going to showcase them today. And just different ways to style. We can start with the ensemble that I'm wearing. I have on a nice pair of Sullivan Slim Fit Denim, 867s. Nice, rich wash. No real fading, no distressed and repaired. Something nice and clean. I'm wearing double RL leather equestrian riding boots. They are listed, or they were listed, because this is somewhat of a vintage pair. But they were listed as equestrian riding boots, but they give you more of an engineering boot type of flavor. Right? As we move up, I have on a Rugby Ralph Lauren Fair Isle V-neck sweater. I was fortunate enough to find the Rugby Ralph Lauren Fair Isle necktie. Club necktie, wool, definite fall vibes. Just a good look with the Fair Isle sweater. And then the star of the show, as you can hear, that good cowhide leather. This piece, I've actually had this piece for well over a year. I found this on Poshmark and was able to negotiate a really good price for it. Leather coat, polo blue label. Fringes, tooled here on the pockets, man. It's, yeah, fringed on the back, fringed here. Definitely a Western vibe, man. This is a great, great piece, man. I love it. The double RL hand tooled saddlebag, just to add to the flavor, just to add to the ensemble, you know. Great bag here. And finish it off with a double RL newsboy cap. It's almost like a tam, but not quite a tam. It's more of an engineering cap. But yeah, that's my ensemble for this particular episode. Definitely something that I'm comfortable enough to wear out in public. But definitely, if I was on the double RL ranch out in Colorado, if I was traveling there for a couple of days, this is definitely something that would be packed up and would make its way to Colorado. Great ensemble. But listen, without any further ado, let's go ahead and get into this episode, because I want y'all to see some of these pieces, man. I had a good time putting these ensembles together for y'all, so I hope y'all like them. All right? Y'all ready? Me too. Let's go.
For our first ensemble, we start off at our shoes. Black watch, needlepoint slippers, black watch socks as well. All right. As we come up, we have a tonal pair of Glen plaid dress slacks by Lauren Ralph Lauren. All right. So we're going to be kind of spiffy here, a little bit, just a little bit. We got a black watch belt, very nice wool felt feel to it. Look at that. It's very dark because of the black watch pattern, but it's definitely representing. So do you see the theme? We're doing black watch here. We got a Prima cotton V-neck sweater and a wine. We have a gray Tam by Rugby Ralph Lauren. We have a gray estate collar dress shirt. And the piece de resistance, a black watch Bayport golf jacket. So the Bayport windbreaker. Hadn't always been a fan of the Bayport windbreaker, but I'm starting to get into them a little bit. And this was one that I found on eBay a couple weeks ago, actually. I haven't had it too long. But paired up here with the golf theme and everything, just a nice, casually dressed ensemble. The next one, we start off with the Mertens, one of my favorite pair of boat shoes that I own. Brown, wine, navy, and hues of tan. Socks, we went with gray, wine, and yellow striped socks. So you kind of can get the theme already as to where we're going. Here's the wine slim fit chinos. And we got another Bayport windbreaker jacket. This particular one is from Rugby Ralph Lauren. I went to cop it on eBay, but come to find out it was a friend of mine who was selling it. So we just did it through back channels. The chino cap. I already had this. I've had this for a couple of years, but look at it. Wine and navy striped. It's that classic boating khaki color, same as the jacket. And it's also Rugby Ralph Lauren, so it's a pretty good chance they were probably made both at the same time. This particular Bayport jacket has the wine and navy chevron meeting at the zipper. It has a rugby collegiate heraldic crest on the left chest. And as far as the shirt under it, I went with the Oxford club collared shirt with the blue chevron and the white collar. And to finish everything off, the wine heraldic bow tie. Dope ensemble. Nice, classy look. And for our last ensemble, we start off with the Shanley tassel loafers in the brown leather. Nice pair of spring gray socks. And here we have Lauren Ralph Lauren dress slacks in a Glen Plaid Tonal Navy this time. All right. Because our featured outerwear piece is a field jacket. Now, this particular field jacket was online. I think it hit maybe earlier mid-spring of this year. But I was in the market for a field jacket, and of course I was going to go with your usual olive field jacket with the patches and everything. But then I saw this one, and I said, you know what? One, I can get more use out of it. Two, it's more up my alley. And, you know, keep in mind, I think I do still want a traditional army field jacket, but this one, I'm definitely glad I saw it before I made a purchase. I paired it here with a Fair Isle sweater vest and a slate green with a pink shirt, pink and brown, all over skull bow tie. The Fair Isle sweater has pink in it as well as hues of tan and brown. So everything just is coordinated well without being too matchy-matchy. We actually doing some pattern mixing here with those particular dress slacks, but it all goes well. It all comes together well with the field jacket being a great layered piece.
And that's another episode in the books. Today we did outerwear. Lightweight outerwear, pardon me. Lightweight outerwear. The ensemble I'm wearing plus 3 rigs, 4 ensembles. Tell me what y'all thought. Get in the comment section. Tell me what you think of the Bayport. I've become a fan of the Bayport, but I'm just, you know, I may eventually get, you know, a classic Bayport with nothing on it or whatever. But, you know, as of right now, the Bayport got to have a little jazzomatazz to it for me to, you know what I mean, go ahead and jump on it. But I definitely have become a fan of the Bayport. And I actually owe that to my guy, my little young homies, Monte. He has a couple of Bayports, man. And I just really stood back and was like, yeah, you know, he's styling that jacket a little bit. So, you know, that's kind of how I started keeping my eye out. But anyway, hit that like, hit that subscribe, and tell a friend. Fall is in full gear, and we are here. Lightweight jackets in full effect, all right? Artists paint pictures. Haters paint narratives. So don't be no hater, all right? Y'all have a good one.